Welcome to Electron Line. Our next video talks about larger size stars in the range of 4 to 10 solar masses. So they're not yet the absolute largest of the large stars, but they're pretty good size. There are not that many that fall in that category. They're rather rare, maybe 1 out of 1,000 to 1 out of 5,000 stars would fall in that category where they would have 4 to 10 times the mass of the Sun. So remember that stars, the mass of the Sun, are smaller. Once they finish burning up all their hydrogen into helium, they simply go up on what we call the red giant branch, where the core begins to collapse. The collapse of the core heats the area around the core, so nuclear fusion starts in the area around the core, hydrogen being burned into helium, and the star begins to swell up in size, causing it to go up what we call the red giant branch until it hits the helium flash. But for larger stars, from 4 to 10 times the mass of the Sun, notice they go through a different kind of process. When they get very close to finishing burning all their hydrogen into helium in the core, they start burning helium into carbon, and at the very center, potentially already, carbon into oxygen. So what we end up having is we end up having various layers within the core, and then an additional layer beyond the core where hydrogen burning begins. Extra heat is being generated inside the core and the star begins to swell. But instead of going straight up a red giant branch and hitting a helium flash, the same thing that happens in the smaller stars does not happen here. In other words, the core does not collapse first before helium burning starts. The helium burning starts before all the hydrogen has been used up and the star begins to slowly swell and start moving out of what we call the main sequence here. So for stars 4 times the mass of the Sun, they begin to start helium burning, so the star begins to swell up in size, it becomes brighter, and it becomes redder because as it grows in size, the surface begins to get cooler, and that's why the movement is fairly horizontal across the HR diagram before it begins to climb up into the red giant stage. The next, after helium burning starts, eventually carbon burning will start as well at the very center of the core where the temperature reaches a high enough temperature for carbon burning to start as well. Remember that those very large stars, the core already starts at a temperature much higher than what we typically see in stars that are the size of the Sun and below. Core temperatures from the small stars to the Sun vary from about 10 million Kelvin to about 15 million Kelvin, but the temperatures in the very large stars can easily reach 30, 40, 50, 60 million degrees when they're on the main sequence, and then as they begin to run out of hydrogen, the core begins to collapse and begin to have higher temperatures, once 100 degrees Kelvin, 100 million degrees, not 100 degrees, but 100 million degrees is reached, helium begins to burn into carbon, and then at even higher temperatures at the core, carbon begins to burn into oxygen. And that's why you have these various changes in the size and the temperature of the surface of the star until it goes up the red giant branch to become a genuine red giant star. For stars having 10 times the mass of the Sun, it's a similar process, but beyond helium and carbon burning, before it becomes a complete red giant, it also burns oxygen at the very center of the core, because at that point the temperature is so hot at the core that oxygen can burn as well into neon, and so the star swells to enormous size. Notice that those stars become much more luminous because the vertical direction is luminosity than the typical size red giant stars. So they go much higher up at much larger sizes and much greater luminosities. So there you can see that the difference is in that here helium will not begin to burn until we reach the helium flash. Here, as they're moving out of the main sequence and the core gets hotter and hotter, helium begins to burn, carbon begins to burn, and at the 10 mass solar mass stars, even oxygen will begin to burn as the star moves up and higher up onto the main sequence, beyond the main sequence. And that is what happens to these massive stars that are up in the upper left corner of the HR diagram. That's how it works for those stars.
So each star has its own way of dying?
Each star, as they get more and more mass, they begin to burn more and more of the elements in the core before they become full-fledged red giants. So you're going to have all these various layers where you have oxygen being burned, you have carbon being burned, and helium being burned, and hydrogen being burned, and tremendous amount of heat is generated inside the core, reaching those very high temperatures required to do so.
But they die that certain way, but they don't.
Well, I haven't finished the rest of the story yet. That comes in the next videos. It's not the end yet.